of the major energy sources for our body as coming from fats and carbohydrates. And so carbohydrates will get broken down through metabolic pathways into a molecule called glucose, sometimes referred to as blood sugar. And fats will get converted or broken down into fatty acids, which are just the little building blocks of larger fats that we eat, or in particular circumstances, these molecules called ketones. And we take this glucose, the fatty acids, and the ketones, and they get converted into something called ATP, which is like the currency of the cell. So ATP is small little packets of energy that our cells use to run all of the chemical processes that are going on within them. So I mentioned that in certain circumstances, our bodies will make ketones from fats, and that process is called ketogenesis. Now, our bodies will really only do this under a circumstance where glucose and insulin are suppressed. In order to start breaking down fats into ketone bodies, our liver wants to see lower glucose and lower insulin. So historically, what that has meant is our bodies will make their own ketones in a circumstance where carbohydrate is restricted in the diet, such as a low-carb ketogenic diet, or during prolonged fasting, right? So the liver will take these fats and break them down into these molecules called ketones or ketone bodies. We don't store a lot of glucose in our body. So glucose stored in our body is called glycogen, and we have some in our liver and we have some in our muscle, but it's not a lot. Really, if we stop eating, we will run through that stored glucose in the matter of 24 to 48 hours. Now, most of your body can use fatty acids. We store extra calories on our body in the form of fat, adipose tissue. When you don't have enough calories and your body needs energy, it'll go and break down the fat from our body stores and release it so that the body can use that. But the brain is special, it's protected. It's not as easy to get to. And the brain cannot efficiently use these fatty acid molecules for energy. Fatty acids are broken down into ketones, which are water soluble, and they're able to cross something called the blood-brain barrier, which means that they can get into the brain and be a fuel for the neurons and the supporting cells in our brain. So about 20% of the energy that we use on a daily basis goes to fuel our brain, even though our brain is only about 2% of our body weight. We, for a long time, kind of had this conversation, especially in the academic community, that glucose was really the only energy for the brain. It's the only thing that the brain can use. And it's just not true. We know, and we have known for a long time, that ketones are very efficient energy substrates for the brain.